we will work on a scenario where we will be loading unique and duplicate records in two different tables. So our source table S has certain records which are duplicates and certain records which are unique. So what we will do is we'll identify the unique records and we'll load them in table T1, and we will identify single occurrence of all the duplicate records in our table T2. So as I have explained in my previous videos, that to accomplish each task we can have multiple approaches. We will look at the two best approaches to accomplish these tasks. So in the first task, we will assume that our source is a table and we will try to accomplish the majority of the task in the source qualifier override. And in our second task, we will be using the aggregator transformation to perform the activity, considering that our source is not a table but a flat file. The main learnings from this video will be the usage of group by in our source qualifier, the case statement, the aggregator transformation in Informatica, and the router transformation in Informatica. So let's go ahead and see how the two approaches works. So I've already created the table scenario 3, where you'll see that we have certain redundant occurrence for rows ABC and PQR, while XYZ and MNP are unique. So we have two target tables as unique and dupes. So in dupes, we should get the value as ABC and PQR, while in unique, we should get the value XYZ and MNP. So let's see how we can load that using our first approach, which is source qualifier query. So we have these tables. So what we need to do is, whenever there is a concept of duplicate, the first thing that you need to do is you need to do a group by on all the columns, so that you can actually identify that which particular columns have been duplicated. So let's do that quickly. We have three columns and we can take count for the group of those columns. So if you see, ABC has occurrence 4, PQR has occurrence 4, while XYZ and MNP are unique. So what we need to do is, let's give it an alias using case statement, okay, and then we will use it in our source qualifier query. So when the count is greater than 1, that means it's duplicate, else it's unique. Let's see if it works fine, and let's give it as an alias as flag. Oh, I missed the from keyword. So we got it. So these two initial rows are duplicated, while these two rows are you. Now we don't need this count column. So what I'll do is I'll remove this count column and I'll select only the required columns, because this was internally required to set the flag. So I don't want to carry it forward. I'll just explicitly select the columns that are required in my case. So now I know the flag with which columns are duplicated and which columns are unique. All I need to do is feed these columns to the router and redirect to the output. Let's see how we can do this in Informatica. So I've already created a mapping M demo dupes unique separation. Let's quickly drag and drop the source and target. The source is scenario 3 and the targets are unique and dupes. Let's override the source qualifier query. Since we have added an additional port as flag, we will have to add that in the source qualifier query also. let's add it. Since it is at the first position, let's keep it at first position. And let's map it with a similar data type. Now all we need to do is we need to have a router transformation, and we will create two groups in that. The groups will be unique and duplicate. If the flag is equals to U, that means it's unique, and if flag is equals to D, that means it's U. Okay, now let's connect it to our final target. Let's connect dupes also. The mapping has been created, and the mapping is valid. Let's go ahead and quickly generate the workflow. While generating the workflow, you have to specify the connection object. In my case, it has taken the default connection HR. The workflow M demo dupes unique separation has been generated. Let's run the workflow. The workflow is running. It should load two rows in both the targets unique and dupes. So yeah, in the unique and dupes, it has loaded two records. Let's see if the correct records were loaded. So the dupe should have ABC and PQR, and the unique should have XYZ and MNP. So our desired result has been achieved. Now let's see how we can accomplish this using our second approach, where we will not use the SQL override. Rather, we will assume that we are working with a flat file. So let's create another mapping. Let's name it M demo flat file unique dupes separation. Let's get our source and targets. So though still the source is a table, but we will assume that we will not use the SQL override, and we will assume that we are working on a flat file. Okay. So now we cannot use the SQL override. So what we need to do is we need to use the aggregated transformation and then the router transformation. So let's use our aggregated transformation first. Aggregated transformation will give us the similar result which we achieved earlier using our group by thing. So let's pull all these three ports. the aggregated transformation, and let's group by on these three ports and come up with an additional port count. The integer port output only, its value will be count of column 1. Okay. Let's put the value to router. And let's perform the same operation that we performed in our groups. Let's create two groups. So when count is greater than 1, when count is equals to 1, then it's unique, and if count is greater than 1, then it's dupes. So we have created our two groups. Let's put the data in the target. This is our input section we need to put from the group. From the groups, let's put it there. Let's quickly save the mapping. The mapping has been inserted. Let's generate the workflow. The workflow has been generated. Before we run the workflow, let's truncate our table, because we had already inserted the records using the previous approach. So let's quickly truncate the table. Table has been truncated. Let's truncate the other table also. Dupes. And now let's run the workflow. So if you see, in both the approaches, basics are the same. You need to group by on all the columns to identify the duplicates. In your SQL override, you used the group by through Oracle, while in case of the other approach where we had the flat file, then you use the aggregator transformation to do the group by, and then you took the count of the values. So whenever the count was greater than 1, that means the records are duplicate and you need to put them into the dupes table. If the record is equals to 1, that means they are unique. And then in both the scenarios, you use the router transformation of Informatica to redirect into two different tables. Okay, so let's see. It has succeeded. Let's see the count. So in unique, it should put two rows, MNP XYZ, and in dupes, it should put two rows, ABC and PQR. So we got the desired result using both the approaches. The only difference was that you skipped using the aggregated transformation in your first scenario, where you accomplished the entire task using the initial task using the source qualifier query itself. So there are various other approaches also using which you can do these tasks, but these are the best two approaches that you can use in case if you are doing with if in case if you are dealing with source as a table and source as a flat file. So thanks a lot guys for watching this videos. Please subscribe to my channel for more such informative videos. Thanks a lot.